When we were looking at the one-dimensional mechanical system, we had an equilibrium equation that said that, say, dr dx plus b equals zero. So the rate of change of the internal force plus the body force is equal to zero. And we had another version of this also where I said the rate of change of the cross-sectional area times the stress plus the body force equals zero. And what I'd like to now do is take a look at the question of what should equilibrium look like in terms of stresses in the full multidimensional setting. And just to keep things simple, I'll just look in the 2D case. The 3D case extension is quite straightforward from that. And what I'd like to come to is an expression for equilibrium at each point in the body in terms of the stresses. So in the 1D case, we had this expression over here in the box, which was equilibrium point by point along the length of the bar. But now in 2D, we can talk about the points up and down all around in the system. So to do this, what I want to do is look at an arbitrary body, and I'm going to focus in on a point in that body, and I'm going to cut out a square of material whose side lengths are delta x and delta y. And I'm going to try and go through an argument to show us what equilibrium looks like in terms of stresses from this construction. So if I look at this little square of material, I zoom into it, its corner coordinates are x, y, and acting in the middle is, I'm just going to draw any forces in the x direction, is the body force in the x direction. On the left side, I have sigma xx as a stress, and so I'll have to multiply that by the area of that side to get a force. But on the other side, the forces and stresses can vary from point to point, so on the other side, I'll have sigma xx from the left side plus some change in the value, which I'll call delta sigma xx. So that's the change moving in the x direction. On the bottom, I'll have sigma yx, and on the top, I'll have sigma yx plus delta sigma yx. So that's the change relative to the bottom. So these are the stresses in all the directions, or actually all the stresses that lead to forces in the x direction. So I can multiply each one of these by the area over which they act, and I can have a force equilibrium equation. So some of the forces in the x direction can be written out as follows. And each one of these terms technically should be multiplied by the thickness of this two-dimensional body, which we'll just take to be one, so I don't include that in the expression. Okay. If we look at this expression, we'll notice that there are a number of terms that are the same and that they're going to cancel. So we can cancel those out. So the sigma xx delta y cancels, and the sigma yx delta x also cancels. So now I have a slightly different expression, but it's still force equilibrium in the x direction. I can now divide this expression through by the area of this little element, so delta x delta y, and so I receive this equation here. So delta sigma xx over delta x plus delta sigma yx over delta y plus the body force in the x direction equals zero. And now what I can do is consider taking the limit as delta x and delta y goes to zero, and each one of these ratios of changes simply is the rate of change of the corresponding function. So I'll have the derivative of sigma xx with respect to x plus the derivative of sigma xy with respect to y plus the body force equals zero. And so this is basically nothing other than the sum of the forces in the x direction equals zero. So this is an expression of equilibrium, of force equilibrium in the x direction with respect to stresses, and so it involves these partial derivatives of the different stress components of the system. If I go, I can continue with the argument, and I can do some of the forces in the y direction, and I'll get another partial differential equation. The rate of change of the xy shear stress with respect to x plus the rate of change of the normal stress in the y direction with respect to y plus the body force in the y direction equals zero. And if I do some of the moments about the z-axis, I find out that sigma xy equals sigma yx. So this correspondence between the shear stresses on orthogonal planes, we'll see always holds for orthogonal coordinate systems. So we'll always have symmetry of the stress tensor itself in all cases. And symmetry of the stress tensor is the same thing as moment equilibrium about the three different axes, the x, y, and z axis. So in this case, the z axis tells us that sigma x, y equals sigma y x. If we look at, and so these are the three equilibrium equations that we have in 2D. If we count them, we'll see that we have two partial differential equations plus one algebraic equation. So there are three equations in total for equilibrium, as we would expect for a two-dimensional problem. And there are four variables in these equations. There's sigma xx and sigma yy, so the normal stresses in the x and the y directions, and the two shears, the sigma xy and the sigma yx. So you'll notice that there is one less equation than there are unknowns. So when we're talking about pointwise stresses, so you're trying to determine the pointwise stresses in a body, it will always be statically indeterminate. So that's a feature of the full multidimensional theory of mechanics, is that stress determination is always statically indeterminate.